next up, Zach Lund.
Zach Lund knows the danger of throwing his body headfirst down an icy slope. But he wasn't prepared for the peril what it was his reputation sliding away 4 years ago.
I knew the whole time I wasn't a cheater. I know that I was an honest athlete. My family knew it. My friends knew it. Most of the people around me, you know, everyone knew that I wouldn't do anything. That I wasn't cheating, take steroids or anything like that.
The U.S. skeleton racer had just settled into the Olympic Village in Torino when he was banned from the games, sent home for testing positive for finasteride, found in Propecia, a common hair growth stimulant prescribed by doctors that at the time anti-doping officials believed masked steroids.
He was obviously devastated not to be able to compete, but it was really frustrating because of the misinformation that he had had.
Everyone's like, you fought really hard to compete in the Olympics. I said, no, I fought really hard to clear my name. The competition was second after that, you know. What's your name worth?
We all tried to help and support and get it out known out there that he was not a cheater. He did not do steroids.
Lund insisted the only performance he was trying to enhance was that of his hairline. Still, he served a one-year ban from the sport after a court appeal failed. Then 2 years later, the World Anti-Doping Agency removed finasteride from the ban list.
I paid my sentence, I did my time, and now that it's legal again, and they're like, oh yeah, we made a mistake, they're not held accountable, and I don't even get a sorry, I don't even get acknowledgement. And that's hard.
Seeking a fresh start, Lund shaved his head. And while he no longer struggles with his outward appearance, he's had plenty of internal battles.
It's the first time in my life I've felt depression. Never understood what that was until after, you know, I was kicked out of the Olympics and my dream was taken away from me for technicality. I've struggled with it even to this day of trying to get a good attitude and deal with it.
Lund will be back at the Olympics in Vancouver. He'll be ready again for the danger and the depression, hoping that overcoming one can defeat the other, and hoping the dream that seemed dashed in Torino was only a dream deferred. Salt Lake City, he takes over the top spot.